Kretschmer came over, the Marquis, to help everybody out, and von Steuben with a fake pole, came over pretending he was a Prussian, and drilled the troops, and Kosciuszko, the Polish artillery commander. There's all these, Mad Anthony Wayne and all this, and Benedict Arnold, who was a superb junior officer on our side, had been flipped over for the British, and then, oh my god, we made him into this horrible villain, and all he did was fucking change sides to this fucking side he thought was more corporately funded, quite frankly. He was like, you know, I've never seen boats stop coming from England. I think... And on this side, there's a lot of molasses. Are you exonerating Benedict Arnold? No. What I'm saying is, when I was a kid, we were taught, like, Paul Revere, and then one woman, Betsy fucking Ross, and she sewed the first flag, like, it took forever, and there was, like, lightning bolts hitting her the whole time, and she was in a hail of fire or something, or, like, the British had her strung up by her ankles, right, and she was having to sew upside down while they beat her with a codfish or whatever, and Paul Revere, they rubbed one of his pewter bowls that was shining in her eyes too brightly, and there were so many women spies. There were so many women fighting on both sides, obviously. If George Washington had to marry Martha, he would have been, let's be honest, right? He would have been Dan Quayle without Marilyn Quayle. He would have been half the presidents without their fucking wives. Lincoln without Mary Todd, right? If Lincoln had married Mary Todd, I'd run for president, really? With what? With your money being a country fucking lawyer in Illinois? Yeah! Yeah, Washington was tall, and he was a badass officer and shit like that. In the Virginia War, they had a couple horses shot off from under him, and the Indians were like, this is freaky. How does the white guy have so much fucking power that horses get shot off from under him, and he never screams, and he gets back on the horse? Because that's what she does. But if he had to marry Martha, the plantation and all that, I don't think so. Martha Custer's had mad bread and made a whole fucking thing. And if you didn't know this, he took expenses. He took salary. Washington took expenses from Continental Congress. So he made $200,000 during the war.
But like people really?
Yeah. He didn't get like $18 a week in a pay packet or whatever, they were spending then, 4 crowns and a sovereign or whatever nonsense people were fucking spending in those days. A Sam Adams hat, and you slap it on the counter or whatnot, and someone pours you a tankard of ale, and everybody got around, we're going to the back room to talk about sedition. And then when you spoke, you had to put one hand here. We're able to speak freely now, but in those days. What's the fucking thing, right? Would it be awesome or not to see my company come out and go, countrymen! A call to thee! The Negro is rising! Right? Crispus Attucks, that was your black person. That's who you got to the revolution. The first person killed the Boston Massacre before the war even started was a black man in prison. The fantastic name of Crispus Attucks. And then we know black people fought, even though, of course, there were fucking divisions of black people. Okay, there's actually no division. Black people fought, and everybody fought. In any case, thank you very much for coming to the musical. I spent a little more time on the Revolutionary War. It takes me back to a special memory. My first
Access.